れで。
No, just because people were in the dining hall doesn't mean they're not a suspect.
But the people in the dining hall were. If the irons caused the blackout.
Allow me to cut through those words.
Let's get this party started. The players will have to overcome many trials. I'll challenge them to fight at their very best. It'll be one for the history books. New game start. RPG Maker MV.
Hey everybody, welcome to the NISA America stream for Trails of Cold Steel 3. Sorry for the short delay there, but I'm really happy to get started. My name is Travis. I am part of the marketing team at NISA.
I
am Toshihiro Kondo from Nihon Falcom, and I'm happy to be with you today. And I will talk to you. My name is Alan Costa. I'm a senior associate producer here at NIS America, and I will be doing translation for Mr. Kondo.
I'm Laura, also part of the marketing team. I'll be playing the game.
So we have a really cool thing right off the bat for you guys. We're going to do a world premiere of our next trailer for Trails of Cold Steel 3. I hope you enjoy.
Here are your orders. Survive, no matter what it takes. Let's go. Raging fire formation. Ha! It's down.
It's mine. Ha!
Now. We strike as one.
Got it.
Roger.
Yeah. Ha!
There, instructor. Leave it to me.
Get back!
Mistral Blade!
Now!
Dragon Ball!
Seventh Slash!
Fallen Leaves!
The embers of war are about to ignite. Trails of Cold Steel 3. The legend of Class 7 begins anew. Pre-order today.
Alright, so we're back live. Hope you guys enjoyed that. So that was a sneak peek at our trailer that we have not published yet for the combat and systems of Trails of Cold Steel 3. We're going to be starting from the very, very, very beginning of the game and sort of taking your questions and taking a look at sort of some of the stuff that went on behind making this. Please make sure to send your questions into us at in chat so we can start asking Kondo-san the correct questions.
まあ、ゲームのスタート直後なんですけれど、本当に初めから始まるわけじゃないんですね、最近は。
はい。So this, we're actually starting from what is the beginning of the game, but it's not actually the beginning of the game from a time perspective. It's kind of a flash forward. This is something we've been doing recently with our games.
結構物語の中でこう盛り上がるいいシーンをこう最初に見てもらって、その中でちょっと戦闘を覚えてもらいつつ、
We like to start people off with kind of a really interesting beginning, something that kind of piques their curiosity and also shows them what kind of game this is and the flavor, as well as introducing the combat as well.
あるいはそのゲームの中盤以降からその冒頭に持ってくることが多いので、結構スキルとかエスクラフトとか、もう最初から結構いいものが使えるので、
はい、
まあ、そこを楽しみながらこう。
This is taken from, you know, somewhere around the middle or maybe even a little bit right after the middle of the game, which means that the characters have already reached a certain level of power. They have a certain level of skills already able to be used, including things like S-Crest. So the player already from the beginning has, they have a chance to try out some really cool techniques that they won't be able to get until much later on in the game.
キャラクターたちもですね、中盤以降の、登場人物たちが出てきますので、割と重要な人たちが出てきます。誰かわからないかもしれないですけど、はい、まあ、期待しながらこの人たちいつ出てくるんだろうなと想像しながらプレイしてください。
And the characters that will come out obviously are characters that you as the player probably won't know or have never seen before. And so that's also done on purpose to really kind of entice you to think about, I wonder who they are, I wonder what their role is in this story, and to really look forward to when they will actually come out and appear in the game.
So we're already getting questions coming in here. So I'll start with the first one. Sir Leroy's asks,Is Nayuta no Kiseki canon to the main series?
まあ、ちょっとユーザーの質問からやりましょう。最初の質問は、Nayuta no Kiseki というゲームは、奇跡シリーズと関係はありますでしょうか？
世界観の直接的なつながりっていうのは、まあ、実はその、ソラとかゼロとか、それからセンとは、ちょっと、もしかしたら関係ないかもしれない。
The actual setting for the world of...Nayuta no Kiseki is more than likely not related to Sky, the Crossbow games, and then Cold Steel.
意外なところでちょっと変わったつながりがあったりとか、そういうところはいろいろ想像しながらプレイしてほしいです。まあ、Nayuta no Kiseki ちょっと英語版がまだ出せてないのは残念なんですけれど。
はい。And yeah.You know, there might be some strange places where the games seem like they might be linked, or they might even be linked, but given that the game's not in English, it's hard for me to tell you, go ahead and go play that, but yeah, for those of you who can, please do, and then maybe someday in the future you'll be able to play in English.
So we have another quick question coming in from KEA Bannings, who asks,will you be answering all the questions in the AMA, even if not right now? Just a real quick thing to that. Yeah, we are still answering the AMA questions. We'll be answering them after this stream ends. Thank you so much.
車でちょっとやりました。AMA っていうのの質問は、それは全てお答えてくださるんですかって言っていて、で、トラベスがちょっと入って謝って、すみません、ちょっとスケジュールがパンパンだったんですので、この Twitch ストリームが終わりましたら、やりますので、もう少々ちょっと辛抱していただいて、
お待たせしてすみません。
Sorry for making you wait. And I keep looking at the microphone for some reason.
Another quick one that I saw from Lenio. Hey Kondo, when will you work with Sakurai to bring Rin to Smash Brothers?
Kondo-sensei, いつ Nintendo の Sakurai さんと一緒にこのリンをスマブラに入れますか？
ぜひ僕からというよりは皆さんから桜井さんに伝えていただいた方が一番効果があるんじゃないかなと思います。
I feel like it'd be much more effective for all of you out there to let your voices reach Mr. Sakurai and you can all talk to him and help him get Rin in Smash Brothers.
昔日本の雑誌で桜井さんがイースシリーズのことを褒めてくださった記事があって、僕彼にお会いしたことないんですけど、いつかお会いしたい。ぜひその際に伝えることができれば伝えたいですね。
In an interview in the past, Mr. Sakurai actually is on record in Japan, obviously, of saying that he was a fan of the East series. And so, while I've never met him personally, I would absolutely love to have a chance to meet him. And it's really, you know, gratifying to know that he is a fan of the series.
From Neo Ro, what's Kondo's favorite song from Cold Steel 3?
Sendo Kiseki 3 に出てくる曲で一番好きな曲。Songs.
どの曲でしょうね。でも一つにやっぱり絞れないです。みんな一生懸命作ってくれた曲なんで。はい。
So unfortunately, I can't pare it down to just one. The sound team works really hard to create the soundtracks for these games, and it's difficult for me to choose just one. That's my actual favorite.
Balani Koma asks, with so many games that come out nowadays, how hard is it to try and make each character unique?
最近は、ものすごくゲームが出てくるんですけれども、
はい、
やっぱりどうやってキャラクターをキャラクターがちゃんと立ってるように作っているんですか？
そうですね、奇跡シリーズの場合は舞台設定とやっぱりこう関係したキャラクターを出していきたいというふうに考えてます。でやっぱりその今回千の奇跡でしたらやっぱり帝国で起こる、大事件が背景としてあって、はい、その大事件をこう描いていくにあたってこう必要なプロフィールを持つ人物たちをこう肉付けしていくようなイメージでやっぱりキャラクターを設定していきます。
はい、the characters and their creation are linked to the actual world setting and what they're going to be performing and doing in this world. So here for the Trails of Cold Steel series of games, there's a certain incident, big incident that happened within the world, and so we needed characters that were appropriate to what was happening in the world, and so the world kind of created those characters.
例えば今画面に映っているユーナというキャラクターがいるんですけれども、今回千の奇跡3ではやっぱりクロスベルという場所が非常に重要な役割を占めることになります。やっぱり彼女がクロスベル出身ということでいることで、こう例えばクロスベル市民の帝国に対する感情であるとか、それから帝国の中でも有名人になったリーンに対する感情がどういうものであるかっていうのをこう彼女によって表現していくことが可能です。そこからやっぱりどういう性格にするのという形でこうキャラクターを作っていく感じですかね。
はい、To give you a very clear example of that, for example, you'll notice here there's a girl in battle at the very top with the pink hair named Yuna. Now Yuna's from a place called Crossbell, and Crossbell has a particularly difficult relationship with the Erebonian Empire, which is where, you know, Rin and some of the other characters, many of the other characters most are from, as a matter of fact. And Yuna gives us an opportunity to see, because Crossbell is such an important location within this world and within particularly the events of this game, to see kind of what do the people of Crossbell feel in regards to the Erebonian Empire. What do they feel about a person like Rin? And she's a good example of what we do when we want to show how the world and the characters are linked. And so she's a good, you know, stand-in character for those Crossbell people.
So I'm not going to call this person's name because it's a little bit, but let's call it Triple F. How much does Kondo like Toa on a scale from 1 to 10?
社長の中でトアの1から10までどれぐらいですか？
トアですか？
はい。
トアは結構僕収録直接こう声優さんと立ち会ったりしてるので、はい、結構思い入れの深い。1から10で言ったら 10ですかね。
He says, so I actually, when we do voice recording for the games, I actually am there myself, and I've had many opportunities to work with her, and so she's a character that's very near and dear to me, so I'd have to give her a 10.
つい数日前も日本の奇跡の15周年イベントで、トアの役をやっていただいた声優さんと一緒にイベントをやりました。
So much so that, as a matter of fact, a few days ago in Japan, we had a 15th anniversary event for the Trails series, and she participated in that event, so I got to see her there.
So congrats to all you Toa lovers out there, and fie on the haters. So Nia Mew asks, Mr. Kondo, what goes into your decision on deciding what type of weapon to give each character?
キャラクターの武器についてどうやって決めるんですか？
武器はですね、結構あのみんなスタッフにもこだわりがあって、
はい、
でまずはやっぱりキャラクターのこう一部だっていうふうに考えてます。そのキャラクターをこう象徴するものとしてやっぱりこう設定していきますので、例えばアッシュだとちょっとこう悪そうな武器ですよね。
はい、
でそれとやっぱりその他のキャラクターたちとこうなんていうんですかね、被らないようにあの同じような武器がないようにという形で設定していくことが多いんじゃないですか。
Weapons are something that we think very carefully about, as a matter of fact, and lots of our staff has really particular ideas about which character should have which weapon. By and large, the weapons are chosen to be representative of that character themselves. For example, right now on screen, we have Ash who is doing an attack, and you'll notice that he has a particularly, you know, wicked-looking weapon that's kind of a little bit representative of his character, so that's one way we choose, so that the weapons are representative of the characters that possess them. And the second thing is that we try not to have weapons that... are the same as other characters.
戦闘の時にはやっぱりその武器っていうのはあとあのものによってはその攻撃の範囲が変わってきますし、
そうい
ったあの戦闘の中でのその各キャラクターの機能としての一面もあるので、まあ、そういうところもこう考えながら決めるということになりますね。
And then in terms of the actual practicality of combat, you'll note that certain weapons have different area of effect, and so we have to think of the balance of that as well. So that's something else that goes into the decision making when we choose which characters have which weapons.
キャラクターを象徴する要素としてもすごく大事ですし、まあ、それからゲーム性にも関わるので、そこは結構やっぱりこだわって慎重にやってます。
So in summary, it's important again for the weapons to be representative of the character that possesses them, as well as them to have a good balanced function within battle. So those two things mainly.
Just wanted to jump in with a quick note here. We are playing this off of a development build of the game. None of the text here that you see is final. So if there are slight issues, please be don't be too concerned. We're still working on the game. Got a great one from Kuro Yukin. Kondo-san, when will we have a Trails of Mishi?
Mishi no kiseki wa itsu?
ミッシーの奇跡、なんかこうミッシーでまたミニゲームがこう遊べたらいいなっていうことは考えてますね、
はい、
まあそのミッシーでゲーム1本っていうのはなかなか難しいかもしれないですけれど、はいはい、もうお客さんを楽しませるためにまあそういうことも続けて考えていきたいなと思います。
はい、wow, a whole game for Mishi, huh? That's a little bit of a tall order, but we would like to do something that has maybe like a mini game or something like that that features Mishi. SoYeah, we're still thinking about how best to accomplish that, but that's something we would like to continue to think about and look at going forward.
逆にこうミッシーを使ってどういうゲームを遊びたいかって皆さんの意見を聞いてみたいですね。
And on the other hand, we'd love to hear what you'd think what would be a good game for Mishi to be in, you know, mini game or otherwise. So please send us your ideas for that.
Delta Limit asks, did you conceptualize Rin as having a different weapon before deciding on having him wield a Tachi?
リンの武器なんですけれども、
はい、
立ちにした前に何か他の武器も検討しましたか？
リンは実はもう結構早い段階で、もう八葉一刀流っていう、
はい、
この世界における剣術の流派があるんですけれども、
はい、
まあ、その使い手であるっていうことが決まっていたので、はい、まあ、刀っぽいものにはなるだろうっていうことは実は早い段階で決まってました。
So actually, for Rin, we pretty much knew from the beginning that we wanted him to be a sword user, particularly because we knew he was going to be a user of the eight-leaf school that he is. Therefore, the sword was always kind of there from the beginning. It was just what particular type of sword that we had to narrow down before we gave him his final weapon.
逆にそのパーティーに入るキャラクターたちはこうリンと被らない刀以外のという形で決めていました。
So, on the other hand, that decision informed how we chose the weapons for the other characters that appeared with Rin so that we wouldn't have two katanas in the party.
Moxie19 asks, Kondo-san, what are your thoughts on how the Cold Steel series has been received in the West so far?
戦の奇跡は、欧米の反応は、
はい、
どう思いますでしょうか？
そうですね、まあ、やっぱり空の奇跡やゼロの奇跡、まあ、ゼロの奇跡ちょっと出せてないんですけど、非常にいい反応になっていると思います。で僕ら最初はそのストーリーが主体のゲームというのがこうなかなか欧米では受け入れられないよっていうことを言われながら、まあ、これ今までやってきたので、まあ、線路奇跡をきっかけにまたちょっとそういったゲームを楽しんでくれる方がまあ増えてくれて、まあ、非常に喜ばしくなってます、ね。
Well, even in Japan, you know,、both Sky Trilogy and then the two Crossbow games, which unfortunately, and sorry, have not been released out here, have been pretty well received. And originally, when we first started trying to do, you know, very really story-focused games like this, we were kind of told that these wouldn't be super successful in the West. But what we've actually seen is that people really do like them. And then, well, with the release of the Cold Steel series, the reaction's been very, very good. So overall, we're very, you know, pleased with people's reaction to these games.
Mino780, I believe you have a bit of a long question, so I'm just going to boil it down to the base here. What were the inspirations for the introduction of the Combat Link system and the popular Divine Knight battle system?
Link no... One more time? What's the inspiration for the Link system?
For the Link system?
Link system no inspiration はどこから来ましたでしょうか。
もともとこのゲームを始めたときに、まあ、7組の、メンバーたちの絆をこう描いていくということが、まあ、シナリオで決定していて、でバトルもやっぱりその仲間を重視したのをこうやりたいというふうに、まあ、シナリオスタッフから相談を受けてたんですね。でそこからやっぱりこう、まあ、リンクアタックっていう言葉だけが先にできていて、
はい、
どういうものか決まってなかったまあそれをやっぱり考えていく段になって、やっぱりこう仲間同士がこう連携するものがやっぱり、ね、その連携の仕方がちょっとずつパワーアップしていくようなシステムがやっぱりいいんじゃないかというところから始まっていって、はい、で、まあ、なかなかただその4人いっぺんに連携したりするとちょっと操作も複雑になりそうだし、考えないといけないことも増えそうだったので、まあ、シンプルに、
はい、
まあ、2人で連携するというところから始まって、
はい、
今のシステムになったという経緯ですね。
はい。So for the link system, this actually is an example of the gameplay being informed by the story. So we knew very early on that we wanted the story of Trails of Cold Steel to portray bonds between people. And so within that, we thought, how could we portray these bonds, you know, that they forge with one another in a gameplay way? And what we came up with was the link attack. Now, the funny thing is that we actually had the name Link Attack before we knew what exactly the Link Attack was going to be. So once we'd come up with that name, we had to think about, okay, so what actually is going on here? And so one thing that we considered was to have all four members participate, but that became very difficult to execute on a kind of a fundamental level of what we wanted to do. So we've simplified that into the way you see it now, which is, you know, two characters having a link together. And, you know, it's persisted throughout the Trails of Cold series. Trails of Cold Steel series up until now. 2番目の質問は何か
あります。
ごめんなさい、
なんだっけ、あ、そうそう、もともと奇跡シリーズはあとはそのバトルに時間がかかるっていう意見がとても多かったので、
はい、
まあ、このリンクシステムを入れることでこう戦闘の時間をこう圧縮できるんじゃないかなっていうところもあって、まあ、1回攻撃すれば普通終わりなんですけど、そこに仲間が連携することでやっぱりダメージを与える、はい、時間っていうのがやっぱりこう繰り上がれるので、まあその分戦闘がこうスムーズになるんじゃないかなっていう思いもあって採用したということになります。
And there's actually another reason too. And that reason is that some of the feedback we'd received for these games is that the battle was a little bit slow-paced. And so what we wanted to do is that having link attacks allows you to kind of shorten that time that it takes to perform an action in battle. You can add additional damage to your enemy in battle to kind of make battles a little bit more snappy and more smooth. And so that's another reason we decided to use this system.
で、彼の2番目の質問は、鬼神戦闘はどこから来たんですか？
鬼神戦はですね、やっぱりその、まあ、いわばその巨大ロボですね。で、まあ、僕ら日本人は結構巨大ロボが好きですけども、せっかくまあそれが出てくるのに、その戦闘に参加しないのもおかしいじゃないかっていうスタッフが、まあ、やっぱり意見としてあげてきたのがきっかけですよね。
Well, you know, when it comes to Divine Knights, we're Japanese and we love giant robots. So we thought that it would be really weird to have them appear in the game but not have the player actually be able to, you know, use them in combat and for them to not appear in combat. So that's why, those are the simple reasons for why we decided to do that.
まあ、ただその毎回バリマールが出てきて戦闘に参加してくれるとそのリーンたちは戦わなくてよくなってしまうので、はい、まあ、ある程度制限をつけて力を借りることができるというシステムになりました。
But I mean honestly if Rin and his classmates relied on Valimar too much, that would kind of make combat trivial, and it would be difficult to develop the game from that. So we decided to put some limitations on to when and how Valimar and the Divine Knights would be used, and that's how things ended up as they are.
Good answer. So we got a really good one here. I just like this person's username. I like swords.
He said, I like swords too.
Can we ever expect a long running Kiseki anime series?
Kiseki no anime series.
So, the Mukashi, Yapari, some of Sora no Kiseki, anime cast a lot of that. And Sen no Kiseki, Kiko user no, Yono user no Mesa, Kiko anime can you meet in Japan? It did a lot. Sorry, Kara no, ma, anime no website.アニメにしてほしいゲームランキング第2位に入ったりとかそういうこともありますので、本当にあの協力してくれる会社さんとかいらっしゃるので、いつかぜひやりたいなというふうに思ってます。
So actually there was an anime made for Trails in the Sky, and we've actually had many, many players tell us that the world, Cold Steel also is very well suited for anime, they think. And as a matter of fact, there's actually a website in Japan that kind of ranks which games you would most like to see become anime, and Cold Steel is ranked number 2. So we would love, if given the opportunity, to work on an anime for this game, to do so. So it's definitely something we'd like to pursue if a willing party kind of presented themselves to give us some help on the animation.
まあ物語がすごく長くて、空の奇跡の時にやっぱり全部は無理だって言われて短くなってしまったんですね。なるべくだったらこう、物語の重要なところはすべてアニメにしてほしいなと思ってます。
The thing is, though, as you know, these games are very long, and even with Trails in the Sky, you know, we kind of had to omit several parts in the game in the interest of, or that came out in the game that didn't come out in the anime. We had to omit them for reasons of length. So I would definitely hope that should we do a Cold Steel anime, that all those, you know, really good scenes would be left in, and that it would be a, you know, have lots of volume to it.
So,
those of you who work for animation production companies, we're waiting to hear from you. So, please approach us with an idea for this.
Get those calls in. All right. MV4. Was there any reason as to why they skipped to class 6 and went to class 7?
なぜ6組をスキップして7組に行った。
わかんないんですけれど、まあこの世界って結構7が重要な数字ですよね。はい、まあ七四方とか、はい、七曜教会とか、
はい、ああそうですね。
まあそういうこともあるし、まああとやっぱりその6っていう数字は僕らもピンとこない。かっこよく、かっこいい。7の方がやっぱりかっこいいっていうイメージがあります。まあ、それからその7組って結構特殊クラスで、
はい、
やっぱり周りと特別扱いじゃないけれど、ちょっとこう寄せ物集めみたいなところも、寄せ物を集めたようなところもあって、まあ、単純にその例えばその普通の1組から5組まで、そのまま6組って続くと普通じゃないですか。ちょっと7って1個6を置いて離れてると、いかにもちょっとこう、
あーなるほどですね、
離れてる感じがしませんか、はいはい、半端な感じがしませんか、はい、まあそういうところもあっての7かなというふうに思ってます。
はい、well you know the number 7 is very important to the overall world that we've created here. For example, you have the Septian Church, which in Japanese is like literally the seven colors church, and because of thatThis, you know, that number is very important. It also has a much nicer ring to it, we feel, than the number 6. And another thing, too, is that you have to remember that the class 7s, both of them, are kind of made up of these castaways, as it were, or people who kind of don't really fit or belong with other places. So you have classes 1 through 5, and then, as you've pointed out, it skips 6 and goes to 7, and that kind of further emphasizes the fact that they're a little bit different from the people in the other classes.
I got so caught up with that answer. I did see a really nice one here from Yo090. With how popular Valimar and Ordain Gat are, could we see model kits of them? I also love robots, Mr. Kondo.
Giant robot 大好き。で、バリマとかそういう機身のあのプラモデルは、はい、まあ商品として考えたことありますか？
いや、やれないかなって考えたことはありますね。あのファルコムって東京の立川っていうところにあるんですけれど、その会社の近くにあのことぶき屋さんっていう、はい、あの結構フィギュアで有名な会社さんも一緒に立川にあるんです。
はい。
ことぶき屋さんにこうやれないかなって実は相談したことがあるんですけど、その時はちょっと残念ながら実現をしなかったんですけど、はい、いつかこうやれれば、はい、チャンスを伺ってます。
はい。Yeah, you know, we'd love to do something like this too. It's actually something we've thought of. It turns out that, so our offices are located in a place in Tokyo called Tachikawa, and it turns out that the famous figure maker Kotobukiya is also in the same place. And at one time we had approached them about maybe making figures for this, but unfortunately it didn't work out, but it's definitely something we'd like to consider in the future.
So an open possibility. See here. Here we go. From Erheller, sorry for butchering the name. Thank you for taking the time to do this Q&A, Mr. Kondo. Estelle is a beloved character and many people's favorite protagonist in the series. Are there any plans in the future for more female protagonists, either in the Kiseki series or in other Falcon games?
Estelle is a character that is very loved by the user.今後の、まあ、奇跡シリーズでも他のファルコンのタイトルでも、女の子の主人公をあの検討しませんか。
あ、そうですね、あの、まあ、キャラクターは基本的にそのあの新しく始める、まあ、奇跡の、まあ、舞台とかそれからあのテーマから決まっていくんですけれども、やっぱりエステルが決まった時にはこう、まあ、RPG の主人公としての成長を描きつつもこう女性としての成長も描いていくっていうことをやっぱりこうチャレンジしてみたかったんですね、
はい、
今後やっぱりその奇跡のシリーズも続いていくと思うんですけど、その中でやっぱりこう女性の方がいいんじゃないかっていうことがやっぱりあれば、やっぱり女性の方が主人公っていうのは可能性はあると思います、
はい、you know, again, our games are really the characters that come out are really dependent on the setting, the world setting, the stage, what we want to do with themAnd so in the case of Estelle, you know, it was at a time when there weren't really a lot of female main characters. We really wanted to portray her growth as a main character, as well as, you know, as a character obviously, but also her growth as a woman. And she fit really well with what we were trying to do with that. We wanted to challenge ourselves to do so. In the future, it's something that we definitely like to consider. Should, again, the scenario offer itself to have a female main character, it's definitely something that we'd like to consider. And,you know, positively, and do should the opportunity present itself. So it's definitely something that we would continue to think about.
Got a question here from, I'm sorry if I messed this up, it's either Ian Nolan or Lon Nolan. For the staff of the Academy in Cold Steel 1 and 2, were there any specific or relative inspirations for their personalities, especially the more eccentric professors?
スタッフたちですね、生徒さんじゃなくてスタッフたちの、
はい、
そういう博士さんたちとか の, あのインスピレーションはありましたでしょうか、特にとあの変わった人あの博士たちとか。
ああインスピレーション、まあ何かから直接影響を受けたっていうことは特にそのないとは思うんですけれども、まあやっぱりあれだけ個性的なこう生徒たちをまとめている先生たちとか職員なので、まあ、やっぱりもっと個性的なんじゃないか特にやっぱりその校長なんかはやっぱり、はい、説得力が必要でしょうし、はい、まあ、なんていうのか、こう生徒たち自身の実力も相当なものなので、はい、先生たちもこう実力を持ってないと、はい、やっぱりおかしいんじゃないのっていうところはありますよね
I can't say that there's any like particular, oh, this is the inspiration for this character for that, but the thing is, you know, is that the members of Class 7 are all pretty unique individuals themselves, to say the least, and so it stands to reason that they would have, you know, strong people on staff who would be able to rein in these strong personalities. And so that's why you see a lot of the staff that works at the academy the way they are. And particularly, you have someone like the principal who, you know, this person needs to be someone whose words are heeded and who has authority. And so that's how they kind of turned out like they are.
まあ、生徒たちもこう結構手を焼く存在だし、こう同僚の人たちも個性的でこうリンを悩ませると、でリン結構板挟みになってる面白いシーンがいろいろありますので、ご期待ください。
I mean, this time, you know, Rin's he's no longer a student, he's actually an instructor here, and so his students give him a lot of trouble. A lot of his fellow instructors and fellow staff members have a tendency to kind of dig at him, and so he's often caught in the middle of these really weird situations and tough situations. So please look forward to that when you have a chance to play Trails of Cold Steel 3.
GamerPrince1999 asks, will we ever get a map, full map of Zemuria? I'm eager to take a look at where the nations are placed on the continent.
Zemuria の大陸というのはいつかの、フルあのマップを完全に、はい、公開する予定はありますでしょうか。
そうですね、今回の千の奇跡で大体やっぱり真ん中まで行ってないかもしれないですね。西側は結構まあ明らかになってきてますので、はい、まあ、残っているのはやっぱり東側なんですね。でこれはやっぱりその今後描いていく地域に従ってやっぱりオープンにはなっていくと思いますし、はい、実際にこういう形になっていて、まあ、こういう国があってこういう場所なんだよっていうのはつい最近ファルコムの社内で決定しました。もうこれからのストーリーに沿って明らかにしていきたいと思ってますので、ご期待ください。
So yeah, you know, here we are kind of rounding out the end of the Trails of Cold Steel series, and we've kind of seen the middle, or rather more the western part of this continent, and so now it's kind of time to turn our focus towards the east, and we'll gradually do that as we continue to proceed with the series, and you'll be able to see new locations and things. But the truth of the matter is that we actually only recently kind of figured out what goes where within the world and on the map. So please look forward to that as we continue throughout the course of the games to follow to reveal this world to you.
まあ、やっぱり物語をこういつかはちゃんと終わらせないといけないので、まあ、いよいよその結末に向けて本格的に動き出したんだなと思っていただければと思います。
はい。And honestly speaking, you know,the tale that we're telling here, it's finally reached a place where we need to, you know, where all tales must come to an end. And we've kind of reached a place in this overarching story for the entire Trails of World, where we've kind of reached the point where we can confidently say that we're about to start getting into the ending and the climax of this entire thing. So please be confident that we're about to do that. Please look forward to it as well.
Just a little side note, we did skip a bunch of the story stuff in the beginning there. We're primarily focusing on the two gameplay segments of the prologue and the very beginning of the game today. So,
how long do you intend to keep me waiting? どちらかというと戦闘とかそういうところに持ってたんですね。まあそういう部分はまあ、
はい、
楽しみにしてください。
そうですね、
はい、今はどこに、
これはもう本当に物語が最初、物語の本当に最初のところですね。リーンたちが、まあ、リーンが第二分校に赴任してきて自分たちの生徒と会って、
はい、so where we are right now actually is this is the actual opening of the game, the real beginning. The Reen's finally arrived to the town in which he's about to take his place as an instructor at Thor's Branch campus. And he's meeting those people who are candidates to become his students for the very first time. And they're about to undergo their very first trial. And that's what we're seeing here right now.
なんとなくその、まあ、リーンは先生になってるんですけれど、まあ、このシーンなんかはこうどこかで見たことあるようなシーンだと思いませんか。
And you know, here it is, Rin is about to become the instructor, no longer the student, but I have a feeling that what you'll see in this scene will be very familiar to you. You might feel like, I've seen something like this before, maybe.
千の奇跡1でリーンが初めて7組の仲間たちと出会った時のオマージュなんですね。
So this is actually kind of a... a throwback and a callback to the very beginning of the very first Trails of Cold Steel when Rin meets the rest of his classmates.
まあこういうところもこうシリーズとしてならではのこうお楽しみかなと思います。
And we'd like to think that this is also kind of one of the fun things that we can do because this is a Trails game. And yeah, so we like to have fun with this stuff too.
同じトラブルが起きるんですけれど、ちょっと結果が違ったりとか。
So, the same trouble occurs, but the outcome this time you'll see is a little bit different. Again, I'm sure you might remember having seen this before, or something similar to this before. And Rin himself feels the same way and is noticing it as well.
This time's a little bit more fun with Altina in the Peanut Gallery.
キャラクターもコメンテリーをしてるんですから、それも面白くなってるんですね。
そうですね。
Exactly.
I'm surprised you're already calling me an instructor.
That is your current designation.
まあただやっぱり大きく違うのはやっぱりリーンが先生になってますので、まあこう前回のやっぱり同級生たちとの衝突とまた違ったやっぱりこうトラブルが彼を襲うことになるので、まあそれに対してこう。成長したリーンですね。今度成長したリーンがこう彼らにどう接していくのかっていうところが一つの見所になってます。
So here, again, Rin's no longer a student. You know, he's grown, he's changed as a person and as a character, and so now he's approaching this very similar situation in a different way. Now, not so much as a participant in terms of these events are happening to him directly, but as someone who kind of is in control or should be in control of the situation and has to interact with his students. So now we get to see a different side of Rin, and we get to see how his life has played out in this new way.
Got a good one from GamePion. Why is Rin wearing glasses?
これはなんだろう、そういう気分を出したかったじゃないですか。
You know, maybe he wanted to put on some airs. He thought that they might look good.
一応はその後はやっぱりリーン自身はもう英雄なんですね。で、やっぱりそれをこう彼の性格から考えると多分ひけらかしたくない、自慢したくないっていう気持ちもあって、まあそういうことをしてるんですけど、でもすぐバレてこう生徒たちに突っ込まれると。
Given the type of person Rin is, you know, he doesn't really want, even though he is a hero, he doesn't necessarily want to be lauded as such or receive all this attention as such. And so he's probably, you know, trying to find ways to make himself seem a little bit more down to earth, a little bit, you know, a little bit more reserved and away from people. But as we begin to see here, he gets commented and he gets called out right away. So not quite the effect that he wanted.
Styles.com asks, what real world countries, if any, inspired the locations in the Kiseki series?
Kiseki series 全体はどこかのもう本当に現実に存在している場所とか国とかインスピレーションですか？
そうですね。リベール王国を、まあ、デザインっていうか設定した時は、まあ、やっぱりその、まあ、誇りある独立を保っていた、まあ、侵略されそうになったけれど、まあ一回のどこかの占領下になったことはなくて、ずっと独立を保ってきたっていうことで、まあちょっと意外かもしれないんですけど、東南アジアのタイっていう国がやっぱりそうなんですね。
So, Liberia, for example, is a country that throughout its history has never been occupied or overcome by any outside invaders. And believe it or not, the inspiration for that comes from Southeast Asia, from the country of Thailand.
どことなくそのリベール王国の地図もちょっとタイに似てるんです。半島が突き出てて。
And as a matter of fact, if you look at the actual geography of Liberia, you'll notice that it has like a little peninsula at the bottom, which is kind of modeled on the map of Thailand itself as well. So.
ただ風光明媚でこう国のどこからも湖や山が見えるっていうところはちょっとヨーロッパを感じました。
But when it comes down to the actual, you know,nuts and bolts of what comprises this country in terms of like the lakes and the mountains and things like that, that's definitely got more of a European flavor to it.
逆にその経済特区でいろいろそのそれゆえにちょっとトラブルがあったりとかいうところはもしかしたら香港とかそういうイメージかもしれません。
はい。And then for countries, you know, or in from
すべて
ですね。今そう思ったんです。And then when it comes to a country like Crossbell, even though it's kind of got, it has a very strong financial position and is important in a financial sense, it also has its own various issues, which you'll see in the Cold Steel games. And that's some, that comes from a place like Hong Kong, for example. And then Erebonia is probably pretty obvious, but you know, Germany would be the what we're giving the nod to here.
Card 03 asks, Kondo-san, are you a Gundam fan?
The little conversation we had was a little bit more of the usage of the word. This is kind of new to me too. I guess the word fan has quite the strong connotation to it, and so at first he was reluctant to call himself a fan of the series, saying that he liked it, but I let him know that more in English, you know, fan is, it can be more of a casual like, so it sounds like he's not a super fan, but he is definitely a fan of Gundam. He said, I'm the kind of fan that gets that the actual, the real hardcore fans of Gundam get angry at in Japan.
So.
He said, also, why on, where did that question come from?
I am getting them a little bit out of order, so I think it was back from the giant robot part.
Ah, this is a little bit old question. Makes sense.
AceShark92, I'm going to boil down your question into sort of the sort of digestible parts. Basically, where did the change, the idea for the change come from the opening of Cold Steel 1 and 2 being still frame and Cold Steel 3 and 4 being animated intros?
これ OP についてなんですけれども、戦の奇跡の1と2はまあ基本的に動かないイメージで作られているんですけれども、今回はフルードのモーションなんですけども、それなぜですか？
まあワンツーまではファルコンの社内で
使ったんです。はい。
で、まあ、ファルコンのオープニングってずっとそのやり方をしてきたんですけれども、はい、まあ、やっぱり戦の奇跡ワンツーをこう残ろうっていう。ファルコムっていろんな作業をこう兼任することがあって、オープニングを作ったスタッフはオープニング専用のスタッフという、ムービー専用スタッフではなくて、普段普通にキャラクターのモデルとかモーションを作ってるスタッフがなるべく作業を早く終わらせた後にオープニングの制作に入るんですよ。だそれだとこうやっぱりゲームの規模がどんどんどんどん大きくなっていって、こうオープニングまでちょっと彼らではとても手が回らないという状況に最近なって、そこからまあやっぱりそのオープニングに関してはちょっと一回外部 の, そのアニメーション制作会社にお願いしてみようかっていうところからこうテスト的に始めてみてるという感じですか。
はい。So the reason for this is that actually the opening movies for Trails of Cold Steel 1 and 2 are made in-house. The thing to note though is that we don't have an in-house kind of motion graphics team or a team dedicated to making the movies. These are actually people on staff whose main job is art, modeling and graphics and things like that. And so they generally would begin to work on these things after their main work was done. However, as the scale and scope of these games has grown over the years, it became to the point where they just didn't have the capacity to be able to work on this as well as to perform their normal duties to get everything in the game. And so kind of as a trial, we decided to use an outside company, and we hired an outside animation studio to create the animation for Trails of Cold Steel 3, which is why it's different from the style of 1 and 2. Incidentally, up until now, pretty much all of our games, we've always done the opening movies in-house.
From Delta Limit, did Millium become more powerful than Altina between Sin 2 and to 3? Or is that just the power of a Kaseki entrance?
ミリアムが戦の奇跡2と3の間にアルティナより強くなりましたか、なんかそれか、まあ、オープニングの、まあ、彼女が登場するときにその登場シーンに合わせた力を見せ方だったでしょうか。多分先ほどのあれが出てくるんじゃないですか、ミリアムが一番最初にプレイしたシーンで、
はい、
ミリアムが出て
くる、リンと一緒に登場するシーン、
ただものすごくパワフルに見えるんですから、まあ、多分半分ジョークで言ってると思うんですけれども、その2と3の間にアーティナより超えた
その
力のところは、
もともと3 そんなに大きく力の差があったかどうかっていうのは分からないんですけど、ただ人間的な部分としてのそのミリアムの成長っていうのはやっぱりすごく大きいんじゃないですか。
はい。Sorry, I'm personally impressed by that answer. So in terms of their actual true power level, I can't say, you know, which one is more powerful. But thinking about the events of previous games, wouldn't you say that Milliam has maybe had more chances to grow as a person more than Altina maybe? So maybe that has something to do with how that looked.
This one is actually kind of for us here, like Laura behind the controller. But Key79 wants to know, did they add a turbo function for the Western version?
Turbo, you mean like speed up your attacks?
The high speed mode or
click in the, on the right side of the...
So like during combat?
No, just the right side, the right side of the touchpad.
Oh.
Oh,
there we go.
So that's...
Oh, that's true.
I just thought it was something that we could reveal.
Actually, Japanese版にはなかったんですけれども、まあ、欧米版の線路奇跡3にはあのハイスピードモードが最初から搭載されています 。
はい。Actually, as a matter of fact, this mode wasn't in the Japanese version of the game, but we thankfully were able to add it to the Western release of the game, so please look forward to that.
やっぱりあの奇跡シリーズは結構あの何度も遊びたいとか、あとはやり込みたいっていうユーザーさんがたくさんいらっしゃって、で、やっぱり彼らがあのハイスピードモード線路奇跡ワンツー回にあの入れた時にすごく好評だったんですね、
はい
はい、それからやっぱりその線路奇跡4にも載せたんですけど、線路奇跡3だけはちょっと空白地帯になってしまって、
はい、
でまあ北米版を出すことになって社長どうしましょうっていう相談が来たんで、
はい、
まあやっぱりこれはあのこれだけ好評だったのをやらないのはちょっとこうあまりユーザーさんにとってはよろしくはないよねってことで、まあ、北米版の3にはあのハイスピードモードきちんとあの導入してますので。
はい。So the thing is that you know, there's lots of people who like to do multiple playthroughs of these games, and in doing so, high speed mode is a really great feature to help them get through that. We actually added this feature for the in Japanese they're called the Kai, I guess you could say remasters of 1 and 2, and they were very very well received, and we also included it in 4. And so when it came time for this game to, you know, begin to come out in the West, we actually had, because again, this, the Trails of Cold Steel 3 in Japan never had this feature added to it. The staff asked me and said, is this a feature that you think we should put inside the game? And I said, oh, you know, absolutely. This is something that, again, is something people really like. It really helps in their in subsequent playthroughs of the game. So it's a feature we very happily were able to add to this version of the game.
Stairmaster asks, Kondo-san, what games do you enjoy playing?
社長は、まあ、ファルコムさん多分以外の人になると思うんですけど、はい、どんなゲームが好きですか自分がプレイするとき。
結構まあいろんなゲームを遊ぶんですけれど、はい、割とやっぱりゲームの参考にしたいなって、あと UI とかいつもすごいなと思うのがやっぱりペルソナシリーズですよね。
はい。I try to, you know, I have always tried to and do try to play lots of different games. I also try to play games that I think will be beneficial for us to, you know, look at as examples for when we make our games. And one that really, particularly in regards to UI, and one that really impressed me was Persona.
やっぱりあと映画的な演出でこう日本の会社にはなかなか実現できないものでやっぱりすごいなと思うのは、まああのアンチャーテッドとかゴッドオブとか、それも新作が出れば必ず。
And then from another angle, that of animations and kind of movies and things like that, things that kind of relate to the story, I always make it a point to play new Uncharted games and God of War games and kind of reference that and how they do that.
家に帰ると子供たちとスマブラで遊んだりすることもありますし、あとあの一番上の子供なんかとはこうワールドオブタンクスやつの時もあります。
はい。And then when I go home, I like to play Smash Brothers with my kids, and then with my oldest child, we play World of Tanks together.
We got a question from our YouTube audience. Will Cold Steel 3 allow for free traveling between previous visited areas, like in Cold Steel 2?
線の奇跡2と同じように、線の奇跡3ではすでにあの行ったところはもう一度行けるんですか？
戻ることもできるとかそういうことですか。そうですね、まあ、千の奇跡3は割とまあ、物語が結構順番に進んでいく形式をとっていて、
はい、
まあ、地域ごとにこう、はい、7首の子たちと移動してそこをこう攻略していくっていう、どっちかというと千の奇跡1 の、 スタイルに近いですね。
For this one actually, this is a lot more similar to Trails of Cold Steel 1 in that you'll go to different places with your class,your students, and then you'll do what needs to be done there and kind of move on to the next. So again, it's more similar to Trails of Cold Steel 1.
ただ 1-2 が帝国の東側だったのに対して、まあ、千の奇跡3って帝国の西側を今度新しい地域として旅することになるので、はい、まあ、十分に楽しめるんじゃないかなと思います。
はい、You gotta remember though too, with the Trails of Cold Steel 1 and 2, it portrays the eastern side of the Erebonian Empire,whereas this time, for the first time, we're showing off the western side of the empire. So there's lots of new things to see, and I'm sure you'll all enjoy visiting these new places.
Mythos Dragon asks, who writes all the little NPC vignettes?
Ah, NPC の、まあ、会話とストーリーを誰が書くんですか？
NPC のストーリー誰がスタッフですか？
まあそうですね。すどなたが担当するという質
問。まあ基本的にはファルコムの社内のシナリオライターが担当してますね。
はい、
ただものすごい膨大な量なので、その NPC のメッセージ書くときには結構。みんなで手伝わないと終わらないと、社内でこうシナリオをかける人間はその時期に、まあ、集合して、はい、一気に作成していきます、
はい、じゃあ基本的に一人なんですけれども最後になるときはもう皆さんちょっと
メインシナリオは大体その2人ぐらいで書くんです、ね、
はい、
でそのメインシナリオを書く人間とは別にこう、
はい、
クエストの担当者と NPC の会話のメッセージの担当者がいます。
なるほど。
どっちかというとそっちのメンバーが中心になって
進めます。わ
かりました。
So for the overall game, there's basically two people who work on the overall main story, and then in terms of quests and NPC dialogue and things like that, there's two other people who are mainly in charge of doing those or taking care of those areas. So that's kind of how that division of labor works out. But they're all it's all in staff people.
空の奇跡の時はスタッフが少なかったんで。僕が書いてました。
when it comes to the Trails in the Sky series, we didn't have many members on staff, so I was the one who actually wrote all of that dialogue.
Coolispo asks, Mr. Kondo, what is your opinion on Western-style open-world RPGs such as the Elder Scrolls or Witcher series?
Kondo 社長は、WRPG、Open World Style、例えば The Witcher とか Skyrim とかどう思いますか？
はい、やっぱりオープンワールドはオープンワールドにしかこうできないゲームの楽しみ方があって、やっぱりすごいなとやっぱり思いますね。遊んでてもやっぱり楽しいですし。
There's absolutely something that only open world style games can offer, and I enjoy them for what they are, and I appreciate what they bring to the table.
よくそのアジアでもその欧米でもたまにそのユーザーさんから奇跡シリーズはオープンワールドにしないんですかっていう話をいただくことがあるんですけど、奇跡シリーズはやっぱり今のところはちょっと難しいと思っていて、というのはやっぱりその物語が非常に緻密なので、まあ、やっぱりこの結末に向けてこういう順番でストーリーを楽しんでほしいっていうのをこう細かくきちんと設計してやっぱり組み立てていくわけですね。でやっぱりオープンワールドだとこう好きなタイミングでこう好きな地域にやっぱり出入りできてしまって、その初めてその地域に行った時の感動みたいなものを表現できないわけですよ。そういうところはやっぱりこう奇跡シリーズのアイデンティティとしてやっぱり順番通りに地域を回っていくっていうところはしばらくはやっぱり伝統として続けていきたいなというふうに思ってます。
And as kind of an aside, you know, we actually have gotten some feedback, mainly from people outside of Japan and Asia, and then sometimes in Japan as well, but have you considered making the Trails series an open world series? And to that I'd have to say probably the answer is no. And the reason for that is that the stories that we create are so detailed, it's really hard to allow for the level of freedom that open world games kind of necessarily require in terms of being able to go here and there and everywhere in any order that you want. Whereas with our games, because the story is so focused, it's pretty important for us that the player goes to this place and then that place and that place, and that these the order for the places that you visit and the scenes that you see follow one another very closely. So for now, we'll definitely continue making the Trails games as we always have, and this is kind of, you know, the legend and the tradition that this series has.
CTC Sauron asks, what was the inspiration for the Orbment system?
Orbment system の由来というか、インスピレーションは何でしょうか。
もともとその空の軌跡を一番初めに考えたときに、まあ、今まで、まあ、英雄伝説で、まあ、やったことのない世界観をやりたいねっていう話になったんですね。で、その時にやっぱりその産業革命期のこうヨーロッパのイメージ、ちょっとスチームパンク入れつつそういうことができないかなって話した時にこうやっぱり魔法をこう何かのギミックで発動させるのはどうだろう、はい、で機械やっぱりいいねと、はい、なんとかイメージとしてはやっぱり機械式時計がいいんじゃないかって、
はいはい、
あのなんか資料を探してこようって、まあ、シナリオのパートナーと話をして2人次の日来たら全く同じ本を持ってて、
すごい
機械式時計の本を偶然買って、はい、でやっぱり表紙にすごく綺麗な歯車が並んで、はい、まあ、やっぱりその機能としてではなくなんかこう芸術みたいな美しさがあったんですね、うん、でこれを使ってやっぱり魔法を起動させるとこうちょっと変わってて面白いんじゃないかというところがあって、そこからまああの時計のムーブメントという言葉と、まあ、ファンタジーっぽいオーブっていう言葉を組み合わせてオーブメントという、はい、設定が生まれました。はい、
So this actually, what we wanted is, we really, when we started working on the Trails series, Trails in the Sky, we wanted to have a world setting that was hitherto not seen in any of the previous Legend of Heroes games. And so within this world, we decided that we wanted to kind of base it on the Industrial Revolution in Europe. And then within that, we thought, well, we still need to have magic and we need something that allows people to use magic. And so my writing partner and I, we thought, well, what can we do to, you know, have people be able to use magic? And so we left work that day and we came back to work the next day with the intent of, you know, researching things and then coming back and seeing and talking about what we had found. And it turns out that we actually came back with the exact same book, and it was a book about mechanical watches. Mechanical watches have something inside them called movements. And in addition to being a instrument of, you know, extreme practicality in telling time, they also have a really beautiful artistic sense to them too, and how they're made and how they're arranged. And so we actually took, the word orbment is actually a portmanteau of those two different words, the ment from a watch and then orbs, so orbment. And we decided that the characters of our world would use these orbments in order to cast magic and to use magic.
Yes, thank you.
You're finished. Funny. asks, what is the process for composing music for these games? Are songs composed for specific scenarios, or are the songs first composed then chosen for the scenario?
作曲についてあのちょっとお聞きしたいんですけれども、
はい、
シーンがあって曲を作るんですか、それとも逆に、まあ、曲をいくつか作ってでそれああの当てはまるシーンに当てはまりますか。
両方ですかね。あのシナリオが出来上がってくれば、まあ、当然サウンドチームもこうそれを見て、まあ、やっぱインスピレーションを受けて、
はい、
このシーンにあった曲を書いてやろうとか、このボスのテーマ曲を書いてやろうとか、このヒロインのテーマを作ってみようってなるんですけど、シナリオができる前は逆にこう、まあ、想像でとにかくいい曲を書くっていうことでどんどん書き溜めていくんです、
はい、
でそういった曲の中からこう結構いい曲が出てきたと思って、こんなにいい曲があるんだったらじゃあちょっとここに使おうとか、オープニングにしちゃおうとか、メインテーマにしようっていうこともあります。
はい。Actually, it's a little bit of both. And the times when we were able to kind of finish the scenario or at least solidify parts of the scenario at an earlier level, we share that with the sound team and then they receive inspiration from what's been written, in terms of, oh, well, you know, this would be, there's this boss in the game, so we can make a theme like this, or there's this heroine, we really want to make a theme for her like this. And so that's one way. And the other way is that they will just, you know,create songs or themes with the information that they do have, and then, you know, the team looks at them and says, oh, this would be really good maybe for the main theme for the game, or we can use this for the opening. And so it's definitely a little bit of column A, column B in terms of song creation.
I think this will be our last one from Kill Scott Kill for Kondo. Every Trails game has a collectible book series for players to read. Do you personally have a favorite book series that has appeared in the games?
すべての奇跡シリーズでは、小説が出てくるじゃないですか、はい、でいくつかのシリーズがあるかと思うんですけれども、うん、社長として一番好きな小説、ゲーム内のですね、小説シリーズはあるんですか？
どれかな、やっぱりカーネリアですかね。
probably my favorite would be Carnelia.
最初、まあ、小説を考えてた、まあ、小説自体をこう何でやるかっていう話なんですけれども、もともとやっぱりその英雄伝説の白き魔女から始まったアイテムなんですね。でやっぱり世界を回りながらこう本を集めていく、まあ、続きも気になるし、全部揃うとちょっといいことがあるみたいなのが、やっぱり奇跡シリーズにやりたいなって取り入れて、まあ、小説も毎回書くの結構大変なんだよ。お前やれっていうことになるんですけれど、まあ、その中でこうカーネリア、やっぱりそのカーネリアじゃないガガブトリロジーの時もこう小説に出てきた人物が後々なんかこの人なんじゃないのっていう形で登場してくることがあったんですね、
はい、
それをまあやっぱり奇跡シリーズでもやりたくて、こう、まあ、ただ最初から全部席したわけじゃなくて、カーネリアっていう小説をとりあえず書いて、後から実はこうしたらいいんじゃないかみたいな間につながると、そういう意味でカーネリアがこの一番思い出深いですかね、
はい、Let me talk about why novels are in the game to begin with. This is actually something that was in the precursor series, you could say, to the Trails of series, which is the Gargoff trilogy. There were these novels in that game, and it was really, really cool because within that, there is this character actually that was talked about within the novels inside Gargoff that actually ends up coming out at some point in the game. And this character is hinted at and talked about, and it was really, really cool. And so this is something that we wanted to continue when we were making the Trails of series. Now the thing is that as you can imagine, these are really, really hard to write. And it always kind of turns into a case among the writing team of, will you write it? No, will you write it? But the fact that you can do that and kind of have, you know, hint at things and bring characters, then particularly in the case of Carnelia, without spoiling anything, you know, how that ends up relating to the events of the game is also something really cool too. So that's a tradition we were proud to carry on and continue from previous games in the Legend of Hero series.
That's great. I just want to thank everybody for sending in your questions. It's really been a really great hour. It went by super fast. Thanks to Laura for playing, for keeping the screen always going and looking cool. Thank you so much, Alan, for translating Mr. Kondo. And of course, thank you very much, Mr. Kondo, for being part of the stream.
You want to let him have a message?
I was going to end with that at the little bit more. So just reminding everybody, this is coming to PlayStation 4 September 24th. Pre-order your standard edition or the limited edition, which we have on the NISA store. It comes with a plush Mishi. It is adorable. We are going to have a number of panels, activities, new merchandise, all available at AX this weekend, Anime Expo, happening in Los Angeles. So if you're coming down, we hope to see you. We'll also be capturing footage from those panels, so if you don't have a chance to see it, we'll be uploading it at a later time, so nobody will miss anything. We're really excited. This is a great, 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 great time to be a Trails fan, I think. We got a lot coming down the line. I'm going to leave it to Mr. Kondo to deliver the last message to everybody out there.
ようやく皆さんの手元にお届けすることができるので、新しく生まれ変わったやっぱり戦の新しいシステム、新しいルールで、ぜひ楽しんでいただければなと思います。
I'd like to say thank you so much for all of you for waiting. I know it's been quite a while that you have been waiting for the next installment of the series, but in terms of the graphics, the system, everything there, it's been completely reborn and completely remade for you to enjoy, and I really do hope that the wait will be worth it, and I'm sure that it will be, and I hope that you're looking forward to the game.
Thank you again. If you had a question and did not have a chance to get answered, we are still answering on the Reddit AMA, so please come check it out on our games. Thank you.
We'll start answering on the, on the AMA.
As always, NISA America streams every Tuesday and Thursday from 5 to 6:30. Please, please hit that follow, and we'll see you next time.